Okay, we're back. It took me about 13 minutes to cut out all of the top pieces. And remember, this collar piece, I had to cut twice. So it took me about 13 minutes to cut all the pieces out. If you use scissors, it should take about the same amount of time. It won't take a lot more time if you use scissors, okay? So the next thing we're going to do now is we're going to put all of our markings on our... Let's start with the bodice front. Because I'm going to use the ruler to help me with my markings on. There is a method of using carbon and tracing paper. But what designers are going to do is they're going to measure and trace Alright, so you'll see on this pattern there are a few markings, and on your pattern too, there's a few markings, and we want to trace those, markings off to start putting the pieces together. That first thing I'm going to do is, I'm going to keep the pin together for now, but then I will take it ahead and mark, make a mark in the place there is a mark. So. Triangle right here, so I'm going to lift pattern paper up, and I'm going to just, now it's important that you use a chalk or marking paper. It should be hidden in the seam. Marking up in the seam, but not so these are going to be our match points. These are going to be our... Yeah, this is a little circle. It's different than that. It's just going to help us out. And then we also, on this piece, we also have so we're going to now mark for our dart. And again, there's a method that you use tracing paper. I'm just so what I do, I use my ruler. And what I'll do is I will take okay, then I'll lay my pattern back on, make sure that is correct. Is that good? At this point, then I will take again. It is on see that this is a has a curve to it. So what I do is I always start take my chalk up with where the part starts, and then I just curve it. Same thing on the other side. So hold my so we did all the markings on this side, so now we need to do the exact same thing on the other piece, okay? So what I do is I just take my pen out. Over, so the outer side is out. And then I take the pattern piece over too. So it's just backwards, right? So on this side, we have this side down, and that is so I'll pull off and I paint it. Doing my markings. So all of my cheating. You guys can't cheat yet. You don't know how to cheat yet. Everything is lined up. This is the front of your, fabric underneath. Your darts on both sides of your garment that they line up. So now I have darts on both sides of my back. I start marking. Marking. Another marking. That side is eyes. I'm going to do the same process with the process with the back bodice. Remember, this piece was folded. This piece was done on a fold. So I'm going to make the markings on one side and I'm going to flip it over and do the same thing on the back. So our underdress, if we left that fabric there, it would not fit. It would not fit. Thank you. perfect. One side, we do the same thing we did with the other one, we're gonna flip it over. Side. Same thing on this side, same thing with our with our facing. So our facing has some markings, and we're gonna do the same thing with our facing. And then we'll start working on the darts.